Ever since the last shutdown, we have been anticipating the beginning of the next one. That's why we've had this little counter going on there. But maybe we won't have one. As of last night, congressional negotiators are saying that they have reached, in principle, a deal to avert a government shutdown. And as you're gonna see, it is definitely the product of bipartisan negotiations because nobody likes it. So here are some of the details. A Democratic congressional aide told the Daily News that the committee had agreed to tuck away $1.375 billion for the construction of 55 miles of bollard fencing. No wall, said the aide, while reducing the number of detention beds at the disposal of the Immigration and Customs Enforcement Agency by 17.4% from about 49,000 to about 40,000. So let's start there. Those are the two big things. There's also some extra money for border security not having to do with any sort of barriers, but the beds are the new thing as of the last week. The idea was if you could drastically reduce the number of beds, then you can refocus ICE away from just mass capturing huge quantities of people, including complete non-criminal offenses and all of that, and holding them for long periods of time and refocus ICE on actually tracking down people who've committed serious crimes. So initially they wanted to get that number down to something like 16 to 18,000. It looks like they were not successful in that, which this will be the running theme throughout this, which seems odd considering they completely won the last battle in this, which was the first shutdown of this year. But okay, they failed on getting down the beds more than they were able to here. Also, 55 miles of bollard fencing. Now, the aide immediately shouts, no wall. I don't understand what the significant difference is between bollard fencing and a wall. They specifically say in the deal, thank you for the bollard fencing there. You know what that bollard fencing looks like? It looks like a wall. I mean, kind of see-through, I guess. So technically, if you put two of them, you know, sort of offset a bit, it'd be an actual wall. So good, it's a half wall. That's wonderful. There's no concrete walls. It's still a wall, though. I mean, at the end of the day, a fence is kind of like a wall, and this is much more wallish than fence-ish, considering that you can't just, you know, like move past, you can't shake through it or anything. This looks pretty serious. And so coming out of it, they're going to say, we were successful, there's no wall. But any reasonable person, I think, looks at this and says, well, it looks like there's 55 miles of wall, okay? Now, this is double the amount allocated in the last spending agreement, but 10 miles less than the bipartisan Senate Homeland Security funding bill from 2018 that Trump rejected. And that graphic right there, that is Congress in four lines. Because what we have is there's gonna be more wall built than in the past go around, which would imply that the people who are fighting against a wall must have failed because now there's gonna be more wall. But they didn't fail. In the last shutdown, Donald Trump blinked because his approval rating was tanking. If anything, there should be progress in that area, but there's not. On the other side though, Donald Trump, if he accepts this, will get less wall than he would have if we had never launched in this entire thing at all. If back in December he had just agreed to the bipartisan deal that was agreed to, he would have slightly more wall. Now, in the grand scheme of things, 55 miles or 65 miles out of a possible couple thousand miles on the US southern border is not significant, but it is still more wall. And it helps him to continue his narrative that this is necessary. Look, Republicans and Democrats have agreed to this. I guess we were right. And if they agreed to 55 the next year, why not 100? Why not 200? Why not 500? After all, we obviously all agree that walls are necessary. And that aide who shouts no wall, just fencing, we'll see how that argument goes going forward. I'm sure Donald Trump will be very nuanced about the terminology there. He calls it a wall, he calls it concrete, he calls it fencing, he calls it, peaches, I think at one point. Okay, whatever he needs to call it, he will. And if it's peaches that advances his narrative going into 2020, that is what he's going to use. And this deal, as written, seems to help him out in that regard. So in terms of whether he likes this deal or not, I'm gonna jump ahead a little bit. He talked about it at the rally last night and said, I don't even want to hear about it. I don't wanna hear about it. So I don't know what they mean, progress is being made. I think he's being very literal right there. There are words in the phrase progress is being made that he does not know the definition of. But supposedly he's against the deal. I do know that the informal Vice President of the United States, Sean Hannity, said, 1.3 billion, that's not even a wall, a barrier? I'm going to tell this tonight, and we will get back into this tomorrow. Any Republican that supports this garbage compromise, you will have to explain. Okay, the fact that he doesn't like the deal makes me slightly more positive towards it, but I understand that what he's pushing for there is much, much, much more funding. I'm sure he accepts that this is progress, that he is getting wall capitalized, but they of course want more than that. Now, what the question is gonna be, I think going in today is, later on today, Donald Trump is gonna watch Sean Hannity. Sean Hannity is gonna tell him to reject the deal. But hours and hours before he hits Sean Hannity, he's gonna have to make his way through a whole big field of Ducey, and he's going to see stuff like this.
The $1.375 billion, a lot less than 5.7. However, you get 55 miles. It's taken them a year and a half just to start on 2017. Not that they're lazy, but because contracts have to be handed out, equipment's got to be acquired, and they got to get the plans. So they're starting so this week from 2017.
So, I mean, look, I guess compared to people like Sean Hannity, right there, what you saw was Fox and Friends being a little bit more reasonable. But every bit of that about the not wanting to say that they're being lazy and praising the fact that they made a few miles last year, all of that is just the verbal cable news equivalent of lightly stroking the president's head. Just like, you're a good boy, you're doing great things, you're gonna love this deal. And the thing is, honestly, that could be the defining thing right there that causes him to take this deal rather than deny it. I mean, look, as a person who doesn't want to see any wall built and doesn't like the idea that we need a wall being a narrative that has any supporting evidence, even if it's BS evidence like this with the ballard fencing, I would prefer them to just not accept this deal. If he wants to launch into another 2 or 5 or 10 days of a shutdown that is going to hurt him and his party, then go right ahead with that, is how I would say. But I think, as much as he says he wants real wall, he's supported bollard fencing before. Is there any reason to believe that he won't take this and say this is a victory? I think that that might be the way that this ends up going. Thank you very much for watching this clip from the Damage Report. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell on YouTube to get notifications of our new videos. And of course, you can catch the full Damage Report live every weekday at 1 p.m. Eastern, 10 a.m. Pacific on TYT Network on YouTube TV.